Vanderlande is a global provider of logistic processes automation at airports, warehouses, and in the parcel market. Logistic processes still consist of many manual actions, for example in the debagging process, where smaller parcel items that are transported inside containers need to be entered on a sorter. Due to the shortage of labor and the rapidly growing e-commerce market, we see that the market demands for more automated solutions. In the past, we have explored robotic in-feed solutions, but in terms of speed, they cannot reach a human level of performance yet. To bridge this gap, we are involved now in the I.AM project, with the goal to decrease the cycle time of pick and put operations with 10%.
The Innovation Lab is located at the Eindhoven University of Technology, and it is a shared workspace within the I.AM project. To reduce the cycle time, the I.AM project envisions a transition from the traditional pick and place to grasp and toss the objects, so that's more like how humans would do it. And the test setup we have here in the lab allows us to test the implementation of the systems we're developing. And our first main objective is to actually start tossing those objects instead of placing them. And we're using the lab here now to execute the experiments that are related to those goals. Indeed, the big question is, how do we toss a package? What motion should the robotic arm make? And for humans, this is not a very complicated task. And to toss an object onto a target, and you know pretty well how you should toss it to make sure that it lands where you want it to land. But for robotic systems, this is in fact a very complicated task, especially when we start tossing boxes, which can tumble, which leads to unpredictable behavior. So we are building models that can predict the motion of the object after it is being tossed by the robotic arms. And these models are then implemented into a simulator, which is created by one of our partners, Algorix, which is then used for the planning and control of the robotic arm. To validate the models we are building, we are comparing what our simulators are predicting to what we're measuring in the experiments that we execute here in the lab. We have several sensors installed here in the lab. We have, for example, a motion capture system. And this means that we can place the markers on the objects that we want to track within the scene. And we have then several cameras placed around the system here. And the system is then able to track all the objects within the scene with sub-millimeter accuracy, such that we can quantitatively compare what our simulators are predicting to what we are measuring in real life. And at the same time, we can use the experimental data to improve the models we are building. And this ensures the functionality of the systems we are developing such that they can directly be implemented in the industry.
Smart Robotics' role in the I.AM project is to compare the performance of the I.AM technology with the performance of robots in the current industry. At Smart Robotics, we develop robot-independent software for pick-and-place robotic solutions. Also, together with Vanderlande, we deployed various applications in the industry, such as the bin-to-bin robots and the bin-to-belt robots. This means we have a good basis to compare the I.AM technology with the current industry. First, we obviously need to compare the cycle times and see if the I.AM technology has a 10% reduction in cycle time. But second, we need to validate if items are landing in rest modes where you want them to land. At customer sites, we have thousands of different products that we encounter in a day, and we have no motion capture system that gives us information about the motions. Therefore, we'll need to validate if items land where they need to. Before we deploy I.AM software at customer sites, therefore we need to test at this setup. Once that all works, we can move on to the box scenario, where we try to pick from one bin and try to place it in the other, where we allow impacts.